Hello, welcome to the first episode of our series of the critical factors that determine success of your business. And the first critical factor that we are looking at today is idea. Now, how do you come up with an idea? A journey of 1,000 miles starts with one step. And that first step in business is the idea. Coming up with the idea and is not just enough. So I tell people, don't just come with an idea, then you run to look for money. Because that idea has to be translated into a plan. But really, coming up with the idea of a business is the first step towards becoming a successful entrepreneur. And in the story of Uber, we have seen how the founders, Kalanick and Camp, came up with the idea of making taxi services less hassle, more convenient, and affordable. And I want to be very clear that they are not the first ones to come up with this idea. In the story of Uber, we have talked about Fabulous, a site that existed before Uber, that did what Uber did. But the first task of any entrepreneur is coming with a game-changing idea. And in this episode, I'm not just going to emphasize how important an idea is, but we're also going to ask ourselves, how do you come up with a great business idea? Because I get so many questions that people ask me, give me a great business idea. How should I come up with a great business idea? And today we are going to look at ways of coming up with a great business idea. As an entrepreneur, your greatest responsibility is to find a future and then take the world into that future. An entrepreneur really, at the idea stage, searches for change, and it is the future change, and then they turn it into an opportunity. But how are you able to predict and make guesses about the change or about the future? They sometimes use the present information, and they're able to study it and study the changes, the previous changes, to be able to predict the future. And when you predict the future and you create a picture of what the future will be, that is basically innovation or ideas. And you build a good mental picture of that future. And then you now craft that idea into a plan. But how do you do that? How do you come up with a great business idea? I think the easiest and no-brainer solution for you to come up with a great business idea is trying to solve a personal problem. Because you see, for entrepreneurs, they don't always complain, but they create solutions. And I've met a lot of people who are trying to solve other people's problem, but they don't want to come up with ideas to solve problems that they have gone through. And most of the time, if your idea is not accepted or it's not working, it is because you're solving other people's problem. So I think the easiest way of coming up with a great idea is, first of all, trying to validate your own problems and trying to find solution on your own problems, and then try to find out whether other people are willing to pay for it. And I think from Uber example, we have seen that Travis and Camp had great issues about them having a hard time just finding taxi from the conference in Paris. And they thought about, before they started Uber, they thought about how hard it is for you to wait for a taxi to come, especially when you have luggage, when there is rain, and you have to move to where taxis are and ask the taxi people if they can be able to go with you, even finding the prices for taxi. And you know the incident we talked about in the previous episode where even Travis had to walk out of a taxi where the taxi driver was being very rude and even asked them to step out. But you see, that was a personal problem that really drove them to come up with the idea of Uber. Another great way of coming up with a business idea is basically following your passion. And passion is something that has been greatly misunderstood. It has been confused with the hobbies, interest, talent. But Steve Jobs says that people say you must have passion, and it is true. because it is hard if you don't. And it is what makes you to love it. And he says that if you don't love it, you're going to give up when it's hard. But what really is passion? Passion is defined in the Oxford Dictionary as an intense desire towards something. And passion to me basically is the intense desire towards a goal that drives you and breeds a lot of confidence, breeds a lot of determination, curiosity as well. And it is not the hobby, because if your hobby is in football, it doesn't mean that you have to create a business on that. But if you have settled on a business, then it is only passion that will drive you and will give you that confidence and curiosity and the energy and the drive to continue doing it. So I think another thing that will really help you to come up with a great business idea is to be able to follow your passion. I normally say if you don't have passion as an entrepreneur, then you have nothing, because it is passion that gives you the energy and determination to succeed. Even if you are chasing after money or profit out of your hobbies, it is fine. But I want to mark a famous quote that says, chase the passion, not the money, and money will follow. It is the passion that breeds the vision and eventually makes you come up with a great business idea. Another way of coming up with great business ideas is actually improving on the current ideas that are there. I'm not a very firm believer of inventions or very new ideas that are out of this world. And even Uber, the example you've given, was not the first to come up with the idea of the taxi services that they are offering, online taxi services. And we look at so many businesses, Facebook, the great businesses that we have, were not the first. So it is this channel is not for people who want to start very great innovations. I believe innovation can be improvement in the current ideas, and I'm not talking about just cheap gimmicks. I'm talking about great value improvement on what really exists. Uber improved what Fabulous was doing, and they became great. And Steve Jobs is known for saying that Apple is shameless when it comes to copying great ideas. The great Pablo Picasso said that good artists copy, but great artists steal. And I'm not saying that you go and copy somebody's ideas and you do a copy paste. I'm just saying that great ideas are born out of improving the current ideas, and it is just learning what your predecessor had not done and improve on their weaknesses. If you're looking for ideas to start a business, stop chasing after unique things that have never been done before. So it means that you legitimately fix a problem, that you add value to what exists. So if you're looking at great ideas, look at what people are currently doing and find ways of adding great value. Because if we look at the story of Drew Houston of Dropbox, Dropbox was not the first cloud-based storage services. More than six similar businesses were started before Dropbox, but Dropbox became the most successful. So the idea of the first entrant in the market is only dubious. I think the second mover advantage or third mover advantage exists, because when you're a second or a third mover, you have an advantage of hindsight. You're able to see the mistakes that your predecessor has done. You're able to learn from their steps, and you'll also be venturing in a proven market. It's easier even to get funding for such ideas. The reason why so many of you struggle with ideas is because you want to get that idea that no one has done before. And lastly, change the world one person at a time. There is a breed of young people and enthusiasts and entrepreneurs who want to build the next Facebook and the next Google and the next YouTube. They want to build these explosive, successful enterprises overnight. They forget that even these businesses like Facebook did not become universally accepted, globally accepted immediately. There was that gradual growth. And they want to build a globally accepted idea that will change the culture forever. You know that Facebook was first started as a small enterprise in Harvard and later moved in Ivy League schools before it became universally accepted as Facebook. So I want to urge you, if you want to build a great business idea, then first start changing one person at a time. If you look at the great businesses that we have, they were not out there to change the whole world. They were there to change the world of one person. So I think if you want to start a business, then start a business targeting that one person who really wants what you're creating now. They don't want it in future, or they may not want it sometime, but it is that few 20% people or the small world or that one person who wants your product now. Because if you do that, then you grow very fast and you're able to change the world eventually. But quit focusing on trying to build a universally accepted business idea. Restrain from thinking too big, too fast. Instead, focus on solving an idea of one person so good and so well. And if you do that, you will grow very, very fast. And they say that you should focus on building something that a small amount of people want in a large amount, but not a large number of people who want it in a small amount. So I think with the things that we have talked about, you are able to use one of them and build a great idea. And as many businesses as we know, the great businesses we know, they all started from a single idea. So an idea is very important, but I hope the things that we have shared in this episode will help you build a great idea. And finally, and as we end up, I want to remind you that don't fall into the trap of thinking that a great idea is all you need to build a successful business. Remember that an idea is the first step toward building a successful business. And once you have an idea, let it shape, build it into a plan. And there's a lot of hard work that you have to put. And these five critical factors have to be in play. And at the end of this series, I'll be able to tell you where I rank ideas in business. Is it number one? Is it everything? Is it number two? I'll be able to give you my personal opinion and what research says as well in terms of how important an idea is into building a business. I cannot thank you enough for being an ardent follower, for even listening to this video to the end. And I want to urge you to not forget to subscribe, and more importantly, hit the notification button so that you can get an update on the next video, where we shall be talking about funding. We'll be talking about funding and ask ourselves, how important is funding after you have an idea to build a great business? I wish you success in your business and your endeavors, even as you come up with great ideas. I hope this video has helped for you. See you next time. Thank you.